I cannot imagine the call, the night, the morning, the afternoon, the evening, when you know you've outlived your child. Am I missing any other mothers? I don't want to miss any that I may not have called. I just want to thank these ladies for coming all the way from different parts of the globe. They didn't have to take this time, but they did. And I'm just overwhelmed for their support and their love that they have shown me. And we're a group of women we did not sign up to be in this, whatever you want to call it. We did not sign up to be it. But while we're here, one thing that we do together is we're going to praise God.
My son Eric, he was my firstborn, but he was still my baby. And through the years, I've nurtured him. He was a grown man with children and grandchildren, but we still had that connection that we spoke to each other just about 3 or 4 times a week.
They never talk about this, the aftermath of what they've done to our loved ones, you know, and we don't have time to think or do anything. Our first instinct is to protect our child, to defend them whether they are here or not. And we continue to do this. And like Wanda said, you know, and everybody has said, we get up every morning, even if we don't want to. You know, I get sick of this every single day of hearing of them kill someone. And I'm tired.
How can you justify a homicide and you never did an investigation? This is what's being done in our communities.
All of us are faith-filled women. And so we are frustrated but faithful. And so when you see us, you see power, you see strength.
You know, this is a tough fight. You know, we're fighting a system that has been trying to gentrify the blacks and the browns and the Asians and the Native Americans. So this is a tough fight, but I think together, we have to stay together. Stand up and fight.
Where is the justice? What kind of country do we live in? They say freedom for all, but not freedom for us.
But we, the rest of us, can help that so that this ends, so that we're not building more prisons, so that we're training law enforcement people how to be with human beings. How to see a human face, how to see beyond the garbage that we've been taught.
Our children's deaths have activated something in each of us. So we've activated this movement, so we're asking you to move with us.
You cannot sit back and be silent on this issue. It may not have happened to you, but it's at every one of our front doors.
We stand together united. We come together and change laws in our communities to make it better.
We're turning our pain into a purpose.
Yes.
And so as we turn our pain into purpose, from the White House, they'll know us because we'll be standing on their front porches.
Yes.
And we'll be crying out, letting them know that our sons matter. No matter what anybody else thinks, our children matter.
Yes, they do.
So they'll know us all over these states, because when one of them has an anniversary or a birthday for their child, we purpose to go.
Yes.